us everywhere. They think you really care, but myself I can't deceive. I know it's only make believe.
If Gary Glitter was a car, this is what he'd look like. It's the epitome of an aging rocker's wheels. It's the quintessence of jukebox styling, the peak of the fashion for all things American. It's the Vauxhall PA Cresta. Once you get on the move, the 2.2-litre six-cylinder engine is actually very smooth. Goes with this lovely smooth bench seat. You get your arm round your girl. The trouble is, on right-hand corners, you slide across the seat and fight to hold onto the wheel, and on left-handers, you slide back again. The answer is to wedge your elbow firmly on the sill, hold the roof down, and drive with one hand. An interior dominated by a steering wheel big enough to control the Queen Mary and these wonderful chrome switches that are ideally placed to take off your kneecap in the event of an accident. It's amazing just how far car interiors have come in terms of occupant protection and safety. And as you get out, you've got to be very careful not to catch yourself on the wraparound windscreen. You could see where the shape of the Cresta had come from. American cars of the 50s were getting longer, lower and wider, and the love affair with gaping grills, fantastic fins and above all gleaming chrome everywhere was well underway. Of course, under all that chrome, things weren't always going frightfully well with the sheet metal. Of course, you forget what terrible problems we used to have with rust in the 50s and 60s in these cars. Remember when they first came out, they were almost rusting in the dealer's showroom. This is the Friary estate, the estate car that Vauxhall never actually made. It used to send an entire Cresta along to Friary Motors. They would cut off the back end and put on this estate car body. Don't think it looked too garish because the Queen used to be seen driving around Windsor in a two-tone green one for many years. The speed builds up, it takes you back. You're reminded how dreadful these cars were. The road holding was appalling. Little skinny cross-ply tyres, the suspension wallowed and pitched, and it takes almost half a turn of the really low-geared steering just to hold it straight on the road. But when it comes to slowing down, you're reminded of the problems of drum brakes. You had to stop more than three times from 60 miles an hour. Well, you pressed harder and harder on the pedal for less and less effect. It was called brake fade, and it used to get you into real trouble that usually ended in tears.
Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Yes, that'll be the day.
Two-tone salmon pink paint, totally outrageous curves, radio blasting and chrome flashing in the setting sun as you wallowed down to Southend. Was it the height of gross bad taste? Well, perhaps, but I loved it.
That'll be the day. That'll be the day.